We present Tony Hancock, Sidney James, Bill Kerr, Hattie Jacques, and Kenneth Williams in
Hancock's Half Hour.
Bill!
What?
Where's me quill?
Your what?
Me ostrich quill. I want to write a letter.
How do I know where it is? Isn't it in the writing desk?
No, it is not in the writing desk. I've turned it all out. It's not there.
Have you looked in the dartboard?
It won't be in the dart... Oh.
Double top.
I don't know. It does make me so cross. Really. It's infuriating. Well, now then.
Bill! Now what?
Where's me parchment?
Your what?
Me parchment. Me writing parchment. For writing on. I want to send a missive.
Why don't you get up to date? This is 1955.
1955. Don't you think you better get out of bed more often? Now, where's my parchment? You can't find anything in this house, really. I do get so annoyed. Have you been making paper aeroplanes again?
No, I haven't.
Well, I don't know where everything gets to. I don't... Oh, wait a minute. I've found it. Now, a little silence, please, while I compose. Now, dear sir, in reply to your letter of the 24th instant... Bill!
Now what?
There's no ink! It frightened the life out of me. I thought my eyes were going for a minute.
Oh, there should be some ink there.
It should be filled up every morning. There's no organisation in this house. This has got to stop. You can never find anything when it's wanted. The place is a complete shambles.
Well, why don't you get a secretary?
A secretary? Hmm. I hadn't thought of that. I think you've got something here, Bill. That's the best idea you've had since knocking the hole in the wall behind next door's larder.
Get a nice-looking doll working here. Brighten up all our lives.
Oh, I see. That's the way the wind's blowing, is it? Isn't it marvellous? Never helps with the ploughing, but always turns up at harvest time.
I wasn't thinking of anything like that.
Oh, yes, you were. I can read your mind like a book. And one you can't buy in this country, either. Well, you can forget it. Using the same analogy, a word you've probably never heard of, if there are any crops to be gathered, Farmer Hancock is driving the tractor. Not that there will be. There's going to be nothing rearing its ugly head here, I can tell you. If I hire a secretary, it'll be purely on a business basis. Now, let's put an advert in the paper. Secretary wanted, blonde, 19 years old, 37, 22, 36 and a half. Or nearest offer. Live in, £5 a week, more if can type. Well, that ought to attract the wrong sort of girl. Now, go and put this postcard in the tobacconist's window. Now, here's sixpence. Put it in your glove and don't lose it. Any answers from the advert yet, Bill?
Yes, 12 from girls and one from the police.
What are the girls like?
Well, judging from the photographs, I think the best bet so far is the policeman.
Have you opened them all?
No, there's one more. Hey,
look.
Yeah?
This one's a bit better.
Huh?
20 years old. 36, 23, 35.
That's near enough.
Well, has several times been mistaken for Anita Ekberg. Typing speed,
8 words a minute.
She sounds perfect.
I said 8 words a minute.
That's all right. I'll just have to dictate a bit faster to keep up with her. Any Any photograph there?
Yeah. Look here.
Hi.
Hello.
Cool.
My word.
Oh, dear me. Oh, look at this.
Oh, I think we'll have to give her a ride.
What about this look?
My old boots. Fair makes your ears wiggle, doesn't it?
Hey, you realise you won't get any work done?
I wouldn't say that. Anyway, all work and no play makes Jack a dull boy.
Your name's not Jack.
No, but I should be all right, then. How do we get in touch with her?
It says here she's coming around for an interview at 10:30.
What's the time now?
25 past.
25 past? And me with me feet still in water? That's her. Quick, give me my slippers.
Come in. Good morning.
Good morning. Come in. You've got the job. Who are you?
Mr. Hancock.
You can't be. I'm Mr. Hancock.
No, I've come about the job you advertised.
You must be the policeman.
I am not. I'm the one who gets mistaken for Anita Ekberg.
What a mistake.
Where's the 36, 23, 35 and a half?
It's all here.
I didn't mean your leg measurements, dear. Look, I'm sorry, I don't think so. You see, you're not quite what I had in mind.
Well, I'm a bit brought down myself, but I'm willing to give you a trial.
Yes, well, a joke's a joke, and your little subterfuge has given us all a giggle, and and we're all very grateful. Now, up it before I set the dogs on you. I'm sure there's plenty of other places that need staff. They'll give you a job.
Not to a girl of my size. They all make nasty cracks about lack of office space and lifts only carry in 6 people. I usually have to finish up by resorting to violence. I clout them with my umbrella.
Oh, the one with the weighted end there with the rust-coloured stains on it?
Yes, this is it.
Yes. That would lay one's head open something rotten, that would, wouldn't it?
Yes, with a bit of luck.
Am I... I hope you'll be very happy here. You won't find me hard to get along with. Let's get down to business. Your hours are 9:30 to 5:30.
They're 11 to 4:30.
Of course they are. I don't know what came over me.
It was the umbrella.
I guessed it might have been. Yes. An hour for lunch?
Hour and a half?
That's what I meant, yes. It was £5 a week, wasn't it?
It was, but it's £6.10 now. You also mentioned living in.
You're not having your meals here. I'll tell you that. Cider, beef every day, it's ridiculous.
Supposing we discuss my duties.
Yes, well, they're simple. You keep out of my way and I'll keep out of your way.
Anything else?
Oh, the usual stuff. Do me letters, look after me business affairs, sort all my papers out, get a filing system organised, see I keep me appointments, take me phone calls, mend the roof, stoke the boilers, dig the garden over, paint the front of the house and stick me health stamps on.
Give me tuppence and I'll do a dance for you.
No, thank you. I couldn't afford the repairs.
Well, I think I'll go to my office and start work. Incidentally, what's this funny looking thing with the letters on?
That's the typewriter.
Oh, thank you.
I wonder if I've done the right thing here. It's no good, Bill. She'd have to go. A week she's been here and she's got things in a worse state than I have. She can't find a thing.
But I thought she started a filing system.
She did, but she's lost that now. What can we do with her?
Oh, simple. Give her the sack.
I've tried that. Look, you can still see the bruises. How can we get her out?
Well, we'll just have to wait till she's asleep one night and move.
It's beyond a joke. She did one letter all day yesterday, and that was to her mother. Nobody can get through on the phone. She's on it all day, talking to her sister.
Where does she live?
Canada. I had my week's phone bill through yesterday. The pounds column is bigger than my telephone number. It's not good enough. I had to buy her a new typewriter yesterday. She'd been hitting the other one so hard she couldn't get the keys out of the roller.
Thank you.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.